We're all Africa. We're all Africa. Hi everyone, welcome back to DIY with Danika. Today's tutorial is going to be part two of my Queen Ramonda series. I guess we can call it a series now. About a week ago, I posted a tutorial on how to make the hat or the crown for the queen in Black Panther, Queen Ramonda. And today I want to focus on creating that piece of her costume that actually fans out behind her. If anybody knows what that's called, please tell us in the comments because it has to have a name. But for now, I'm just gonna call it the fan. Okay, the fan behind the queen. So I'll post a picture of it right there so you know what we're talking about. For today's project, you're going to be needing the following materials. You're going to need your basics, your pencil, scissors, a black marker, preferably a Sharpie. You're going to be needing some tape. You're going to be needing your glue gun and some glue sticks. You're going to be needing a unit of measurement, like a tape measure. This is a flexible one that is usually used with sewing projects. And I've had this for many years. I think I borrowed it from my mom a long time ago. Love you, mommy. You also will be needing a piece of lace. I picked this lace up at my local fabric store. It was about $13 a yard, but it was on sale, of course, because Danika does things on a budget. And I was able to get a yard and a half for $7. I'm not saying you're gonna need a yard and a half, but that's what I got just to be safe, because it's always better to have extra. You're going to also be needing some galvanized steel wire. And this wire I got from Home Depot. It was really inexpensive. I think it was like maybe $1.50. And it comes with 25 feet. Because we're using wire, we're also going to need a wire cutter. And this came as a set at my local's craft store when I was working on some jewelry pieces. And it actually works to cut this wire. I already checked. And you will also, last but not least, be needing one of these big white poster boards, which you can pick up at probably like your local CVS, Walmart, some place that has it all. Target. We love Target. Now, in order to start this project, the first thing you're going to need to do is to measure the width of your shoulders, because the part that fans out behind the queen, still wish I knew the name of that. Somebody tell me in the comments. The part that fans out behind the queen should not be more than the width of your shoulders, because you don't want to be blocking people on Halloween. So I'm going to be using my tape measure to measure the width of my shoulders. Okay, so from one shoulder to the other, that is about 23 inches. Okay, so now that I have that figure, I'm going to be taking that, and that is going to be the circumference of the circle that I'm going to be drawing onto my poster board. So, like I said, I need to make sure that the width of this circle is no more than 23 inches. I have 12 here. And I think I will use my ruler to help create the arc of the circle. I'll go a little lower. Okay, try that again. Using my ruler, going to hold it in one place to create the arc of my circle. Okay. Wow, I had a great idea. Okay. So, That idea just came to me on the spot. In case you can't see it, I use my ruler, one end as the center point, and use my ruler to guide me as I created an arc for my circle, and it came out perfectly. Perfect. Now I'm going to use my scissors to cut this out. And it doesn't need to be a full circle because one portion is gonna be behind my back. I have my circular portion. That's gonna be behind me. I like it. It's okay so far. I'm gonna be taking this wire and attaching it around the perimeter of my circle and making sure that it maintains its shape. And so far I feel lucky because it's maintaining its shape, no problem. I thought that was gonna be an issue. This time for Africa, jungle. The idea to attach my wire to this piece of paper in order to give it its structure and shape actually came from a YouTuber named Emily Moe. From there, our designs differ, but I definitely wanted to give her credit for this part, and I'll be putting a link to her tutorial in my description box. Okay, I used my wire tool, instrument, cutter, to actually make a little loop there. And I'm gonna bend this one this way. So it took some muscle, but I was able to get this wire shaped around the edge of this circle, taped on to pieces. Now, I am going to take I'm gonna take the wire off of the paper now. The paper was just a guide to help me get into the shape that I wanna get into. So it stayed in the shape, kind of, and I'm sure that once I attach the lace to it, then it will be even more secure into this shape. So next, I need to take my lace. I'm gonna lay it down under the wire. I'm going to cut around the edge and then attach the lace to the wire. Now that you have your shape covered in the black lace, you're going to cut off this excess, because you gave yourself a lot of extra room just in case. You're going to cut the excess off and you should be able to see the shape a lot easier. I have my fanned out shape that is going to be behind me right there. It already looks so good. I'm kind of envisioning something almost that fits over my arms like a backpack to hold this piece where I want it. So I'm considering putting slits in the lace right here and right here to stick my arms through so that my arms come through, but the back still is behind me. So let's see how that works. And what I want to do is I want to hold it here, get an idea of where my shoulders are, And I'm just gonna pinch it so that when I bring it over, I can see that I'm going to need to cut right around there. And here we go. So it looks like it's gonna work. And any lady who's ever had a run in her stocking knows that the key to stopping the run is clear nail polish. But I don't wanna put clear nail polish. I think I'm gonna put glue right at the tip where I cut so that the cut doesn't continue on throughout the entire piece. I'm gonna say directly across from the one that I just did, I'm gonna cut a similar slit. Stick my arm through this one. And that's right where my shoulder would be. Pinch it and get ready to cut it. You're a good soldier. Choosing your battle. Okay, still don't know what it's called. Came out really well. I decided that I want to cover up those edges where you might see the glue coming through with some ribbon. I was going to do the silk braid that I give a tutorial on this page. Check it out, because it will make yours a lot fancier. But when I went to go buy the ribbon, I accidentally bought a velvet kind of ribbon instead of the satin. And it's a little too late to go and fix that mistake. So I decided that this would just be a happy accident. And I am going to trim this in velvet. I've never had velvet ribbon, so this is kind of cool. And it's gonna save me a little time because I'm not gonna have to do the braid this time. So I will show you guys the finished effect after I have glued the velvet around the edge perimeter of the whole thing. This time for Africa. I finally finished putting the velvet ribbon around the perimeter like a trim. So this project is finally done. I'm really excited about it. Gonna put it on. I changed my shirt so you can get an idea of how I'm gonna rock it on Halloween. It's just like a backpack would. And going to naturally wear it with my hat, which I also have a tutorial on. Check it out. And I will have long flowing robes. It's gonna look really great. I'm really looking forward to it. Okay, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. If you know what this thing is called, please leave it in the comment section. And remember, if I can do it, you can do it.